We got a tweet. That's a good choice. Yeah. That's a good choice. Awesome. Good side. Also a good choice, I guess.
Retweet. Hey. It's Kelsey.
Hey.
And Art and Keith.
Hello.
I haven't streamed since September.
I don't even know when the last time I was on Stream Friends was. It was probably with Art doing Hearthstone over the summer.
Yeah.
Yeah, that was probably it.
Yeah, I was in a play, and after work and rehearsal, I just didn't want to do anything that involved talking to people anymore. So that's where I was.
That's fair, yeah.
Yeah.
And I'm about to audition again. So you were busy?
I was just busy.
Yeah, that's fair.
I was just busy and everyone else, nobody asked me. No one was like, hey, Keith, do you want to do a stream? I don't think you weren't the only one not streaming.
No, I think it's been a pretty long break for everybody.
But hey, Keith, you want to do Barkley Shut Up and Jam, Gaiden?
Didn't we do that?
What on earth is
no,
that?
No, we didn't. We talked about it on Twitter once.
Oh, okay. I believe that I have already streamed that, but I think it was before we talked about it on Twitter, because it was a long time ago that I did it.
Oh, all right.
I did it, but I will do it, because I don't remember it, and I didn't finish. That's it. You heard it here first. Kelsey's back, and Art and I are going to do Barkley Shut Up and Jam Gaiden.
I can't wait to see what on earth that is.
It's an RPG starring legendary baller Charles Barkley.
That's amazing. Yeah. So we're going to play Steve Jackson's Sorcery, which I've reviewed.
No matter what Steve Jackson it is.
Yeah, I don't know which Steve Jackson it is. but it's a game book from the 80s, and you can get it on pretty much any platform now. It just came out on Steam, and so that's what we're going to play. Either of you ever heard of it or played it?
No, this is my first hearing of it.
Okay.
Yeah, I thought I'd heard Steve Jackson, but now who knows?
Yeah, this is not Munchkin Steve Jackson. This is Circles of Blood Steve Jackson.
Oh!
Or the movie's premiere edition Steve Jackson. Or House of Hell Steve Jackson.
Or all of the above.
Appointment with Fear Steve Jackson.
That might be it.
Why did you give that kind of action on Fear? Is there like punctuation there?
Because it's spelled like the video. It's spelled F-E-A-R, like with periods in between.
Oh.
So I guess appointment with F-E-A-R is, I guess, the reader assumes the role of John Lafayette, secretly the Silver Crusader, a superhero who protects the fictional Titan City, etc.
Yeah, I think that is the right Steve Jackson. He did a lot of game books.
Yeah.
All right. So part one, the Shamutani Hills. There's a lot of like fantasy names in this. We can, you know, make up our own stuff.
The best part about fantasy names is there's literally no way to pronounce them wrong.
Right.
Yeah.
Everything's wrong. Apparently, don't let Peter Jackson tell you differently.
Or Steve Jackson. Don't let any Jackson tell you how to say a name.
Stop letting Jackson tell you how to live your life, people.
Is that too loud?
It is a little bit loud.
Okay.
It looks like the original.
That didn't do anything. What is... I forget what these knobs do. Tell me when it goes down for you.
It might be easiest to do it just in the volume mixer. Maybe like in a
right. Did that help?
A little bit more, maybe?
A little bit more?
Yep. Oh, okay. That's starting to be good.
There it is.
Good?
Yep, perfect.
Okay, good.
Do you guys know the original Sorcery game book was written between the years 1983 and 1985?
I did.
Of course not.
Kelsey, you said that you did or you didn't?
I did, because I reviewed this a couple times for Nerdy But Flirty now.
How does it keep coming up?
It came out on iOS, and then it just came out on Steam.
Oh, okay.
There's been three games so far.
That makes sense. Sounds like one for each volume of game book.
Yeah, and there's a fourth one coming out in fall.
This Steve Jackson really knows how to milk his old IP, huh?
Yeah. Sounds a lot like another Steve Jackson.
Yeah, this seems like a common trait among Steve Jacksons.
Yeah.
Okay, so... You've walked the wilds of... I'm just going to make pronunciations up. I'm just going to roll right through.
Oh, we can't see the screen still.
Oh, what? Why?
There we go.
Okay. There it is.
Yep.
I won't click outside the thing anymore. you've walked the wilds of Cacbad through Car and the spiteful backlands all the way into Mampang. You've survived traps, thieves, serpents, and vengeful gods, and now it's here, the Crown of Kings. Said the Crown of Kings
sounds like a big deal.
Said the crown was never forged, only found by Chelana the Reformer, a lowly foot soldier who became emperor of the Eastern world. Such is the power of the crown. Should we take it or should we wait?
I think we take it. Here's a crown that turns you into a king.
Right. Yeah, what? I'm not going to not be a king.
Right. As far as we know, there's no downside to this.
Your destiny awaits. With the crown in your hands, you'll be as powerful as Chelana. The goblins are arming, the giants are waking, and the birdmen carving cruel daggers from stone. War will come, but you will prevent it. But then the image of the crown begins to flicker. You rush forwards. It's a trap.
Oh, no.
And startle yourself.
This is going to be really short.
You're alone, exhausted, in a little hut and outpost settlement. Your unimaginable journey is not even a single step begun.
That ankle, always with the bait and switch.
They also did 80 Days.
I heard that was very good, but I had never got to play it.
That's on Steam too. So this is
I heard that was very good, so I avoided it.
I didn't have iOS at the time, and still don't.
Are you still on Windows Phone? Are you still the guy on Windows Phone?
No, I got an Android phone when my Windows phone broke. But I do miss it. Ooh, we have a choice. I think we should test the blade. What's the lowest thing?
Leave the hut.
Okay. Well, that sounds like the boring choice.
I think we gotta pray for luck. What are we gonna do without luck?
Okay, let's get luck.
Okay. Notice that our spirit is a panther right now. Keith.
Do we get difference? Ooh.
You close your eyes and raise this prayer to your spirit guide. This morning it has the form of a panther, but what will it become once your journey truly begins? A great calm descends on you. You want to test the blade before we leave?
Yeah, I mean, we might as well do both.
Yeah, I mean, if it gives us the option, yeah.
The blacksmith has done well. The edge is keen and draws a narrow line of blood. Time to go.
Wait, when he said test the blade, he meant like, should I cut my thumb open with this?
Yeah.
How else do you test a blade? What are you even talking about?
You get like a piece of paper or something.
Someone walks in and you like trying to scissor a paper with your giant sword.
Yeah, I know. Sharp swords, I don't know about swords. I don't have swords, but sharp knives are supposed to like, they can cleanly just slice through paper.
Yeah, I think that's a problem, is that you want your battle sword to be slightly more war-worthy than your kitchen utensils.
Well, I think the idea is that it's you can tell how sharp it is if it can cut it without it, like, fucking up. It's hard to cut paper without, you know, holding it steady.
True.
Are you, like, throwing paper in the air and, like, cutting it on its way down?
No, you hold it with one hand and then you cut the other end with the sword, and it, I don't know. Listen, I'm not a swordsman. I just feel like there's easier way to test the... I'm sure people have been using swords forever. I'm sure someone came up with a way to test it without cutting your hand. Yeah, it seems
good. No, I think
good.
The hand test is the one.
Do we want to...
I'm Googling it.
Do we want to greet the people in our village or ignore them?
Well, we're a hero, right? We should greet them.
Okay. You turn and bow. Some smile and reply, but are too afraid to approach. Others make gestures of protection. You're going beyond the wall, so they believe you to be cursed. A man is waiting on the path to the Kanatopi Gate, the final door between Annalan and the wilds of Kakabad. Do you recognize the sergeant of the Sightmaster Warriors? He holds out his hand. Greetings, sergeant, or get out of my way?
I think we could stay light side here. Greetings, sergeant. Also, my screech ear froze.
Oh. Nice broom.
I'll reshare it.
You're missing this Ant-Man with his broom.
What? Oh.
Is Paul Rudd in this game?
Yes.
Yeah. Well, here we go. This is how you test it. To test the sharpness of their blades, Japanese swordsmiths would tie up condemned criminals and try to cut them in half. So there we go. You don't have to cut your own hand.
But then, that seems even worse, Keith.
Oh, yeah. Like, I want to cut my hand. Like, not going to cut my hand open. I'd rather not use a sword or cut through a criminal or something.
Should we take all of the 24 pieces of gold he's giving us, half of it, or refuse it altogether?
Well, I think that we should absolutely take the whole thing.
Yeah, he's that's coming out of his pocket, right?
Yeah, I don't know whose pocket it's coming out of, but I know that
it says it's from the king.
Okay. The king can do without the 24 pieces.
All right, let's take it. You should buy some supplies before you pass the wall. You must collect your spell book if you wish magic to aid you. And if you wish to practice your sword play, I'll go one last round with you.
Let's do all of those things.
Okay. Collect my spell book. Go inside. Do you understand how to use this, he asks. I'll say tell me for your guys' benefit.
Yeah, I don't know how to do it.
Yeah, I do not.
Each spell is crafted through the alignment of three stars, he begins. The spell Zap, for example, is made by aligning Zarathustra, Aegis, and Pinai. But that's not important. What matters is what the spell is called and what it does. Zap will give you control over lightning. Hot will create a fireball. Foth will create a force field around you. Luckily, I've written all these down in a notebook next to me. Just
got it. Foth is the only one that's less than self-explanatory. Yeah.
Law allows you to control the will of unintelligent creatures. Wall creates an invisible barrier.
Sounds a lot like Foff.
Yeah, wall and Foff I don't get.
Like, wall would be a wall.
I mean, I guess a wall is just a one-sided force field.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Dop will open locks. Walk will shield you in battle. That one doesn't make sense to me. And dumb will cause clumsiness.
Yeah, shield you in battle, create a barrier, and create a force field are three very similar spells, I think.
Yeah, it would seem to be.
Mm-hmm. I'm sure that we'll find a proper use for them. Unless, Kelsey, you said you've played kind of a lot of this. If you haven't, then I don't even know.
I've never used those ones, but I could have.
Okay. This Jackson was instrumental in the starting of Lionhead.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Oh.
He actually got Peter Molyneux involved with Lionhead.
That's cool.
Yeah. And he's an honorary professor at Brunel University.
Today, Emery says, I like the idea that Walk just summons a curved pan to use as a shield. Are we good with buying 6 rations for 10 gold?
That's... I'll give you 10. Let's let's haggle.
Yeah. I said, I'll take 6.
That's what he said. Yeah. That's not haggling. Okay, that's the price.
Okay, sorry. I was reading, I'll take 6 or I'll give you that for 10. I was reading that as our options.
Oh, no.
No, let's... what's the lower thing? The Skype buttons are in the way of reading the lowest.
Too much.
Buy them or it's too much.
Okay. That's too much? I don't know. What do you think, Art?
Is it too much?
I don't know. We could just bring clothes and not get hit, so we don't need armor.
No, this is for food.
I don't know. Is this the... Is it? That's a lot of gold. for some food.
I will say we have to eat every day, otherwise we lose stamina.
Okay, but here's... Okay, so let me... We're in service of the king, right? And we're going out to help the king, yeah, who is night shit, and he's not going to feed us?
No, that does seem irrational, doesn't it?
Yeah.
Well, he gave us the money that we then spend on the food. It's... We're still profiting here. If we were spent this money, we had 14
I thought
gold.
That was like emergency funds for along the way. Like, if you get into trouble, here's 24 gold pieces. Also, here's a box full of food for you so that you don't die. let's buy it. Let's get the food.
I'm going to carry a box with me.
I understand that's
me.
What you wish it was.
Yeah, I'm just... Yeah, you're right. I can't... At this point, it's too late to change how the game's made.
You must be sure you eat every day or you will suffer, the sergeant tells you. Eating more will give you extra strength, but is not necessary.
Can I give you a quick story about a guy I knew in college who ran like the worst D&D game I've ever heard of?
Absolutely.
I want to stress that this is not Austin.
I need to hear
Ron?
The story.
It's not. It's also not Ron.
How
also,
is
we
it
need
not
to bleep
Ron?
That out. This is a different way of being a jerk than Ron, but we knew someone who ran a D&D game where he was like, you're like in the dungeon, you're starting to feel like a feeling in the pit of your stomach. And then he kept like describing like you're feeling this pressure and on and on and on. And eventually he had the guy die because what it was he needed to poop. And because he never
wow.
said, I stop and poop, he died.
That is awful.
That is awful. There's also, that's not like, because you know the feeling of pooping. It's not like every time you take a shit, it's like, what is this horrible feeling?
Right.
He could have just said, like, you feel the familiar urge to take a dump.
Yeah. Yeah, because that's true, right? You don't remember what, no one remembers the first time they felt like they had to take a shit. No one's like.
Like,
no one remembers that, like, surprise.
That yeah. You're shitting before you remember. Anyway.
Anyway. So this is how to fight. You're brought to, a close-up screen, and over here is your stamina, and over here is his stamina.
Wait, okay, we're training with the Sarge?
Yeah, yeah.
Do you think that... He can even come close to us with the broom?
It is. It does look like a broom, for sure.
Also, isn't he a
broom with an eye
Black
of Sauron on it? Wielded by a Beetleborg.
That's good.
So you drag your character depending on how strong you want the attack to be.
Okay, so there's sometimes that you want to match them and sometimes you want to go over?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yep. Like, if they're defending, you generally want to go, like, really low because you'll never be able to do a lot of damage to them while they're defending.
Okay.
But if... a lot of times you just kind of have to guess it, what they're going to do based on their... attack texts, which we'll see later when he just... Because right now he's just telling us, like, my next attack will be weak.
Right.
But in the wild, sure. Obviously, we're not going to get that. Okay, so we won there. Is that enough training?
Yeah.
I think we got it.
Okay.
Yeah. Well, I think you got it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I'm going to skip the actual fight with him, just because I don't need it. It doesn't add anything to the story.
Okay. If you lose, do you have to use your own items to heal and stuff?
No, they just heal you before you leave.
Okay. Well, that's nice of them. They can't give us food, but at least I'll
yeah.
make sure we're not dying already. I should go to the Twitch. I forgot about that part of it. Stream friends.
Okay, so we have to unlock the gate with our spell. Whee!
Art, have you ever played a game book?
I don't believe I have.
I also haven't. I didn't... The closest I ever came to that was like a Goosebumps book, which I don't think counts at all.
Sure. Yeah, I don't think anything that like they like I've done like a choose your own adventure book, but that doesn't count.
Yeah.
Either.
It's kind of the same concept. Kind of.
Sure, but this is better.
Yeah, for sure. I have a bunch more, but
like it's not say cheese and die if you take the necessary amount of hit points.
Right. These gates have not opened since our last champion was lost, the sergeant says. I wish you more luck than he. Perhaps you will even meet him on your travels. Do we want to say, I fear he is dead? If I overtake him, then he is too slow, or that does not concern me?
These are all bad.
I think I fear he's dead is the lesser of all evil here.
Okay.
Because we're just like, fuck that other person, and then like, I don't care about that other person. One of them seems mean, one of them seems rude. At least we could be like, oh no.
This is kind of like your boy's a chump, right?
Yeah. Well, they're implying that it's been kind of a while.
Yeah, that's true. Art, do you like that first one?
Yeah, okay. Absolutely.
The Sightmaster nods, peering at something on the horizon. I believe he is returning, but transformed. I hope you do not meet the same fate. He stands back from you. One last word, he declares. When you have the crown, find the highest point you can find. We will be watching. I understand. We're watching from where?
Watching from where?
Yeah, watching from where? That's weird and creepy.
From here, the Sightmaster warriors are selected from birth for their incredible powers of telescopic vision. You cannot help but wonder how far he can see.
What?
Tell me what lies ahead or enough talking?
I mean, I want to know what lies ahead, but also I kind of want to call their bullshit on this telescopic vision.
The path Hello? Leads... Hello?
Hi, I'm back. My connection died.
Oh, hey. Wow. Do you need to...
Well, I asked for more information while you weren't here.
Oh, that's fine.
Do you need a screen share again? This is a whole
village full of people with telescopic vision.
It's somehow working, the screen share. I don't know.
Yay! The path leads first to Cantapani, a settlement of traders, though most are rogues and thieves. You should be there before the sun has reached its peak. From there, three routes lead on to Cristatani, but no single route is safe. Kakabat is the land of devils.
That sounds like an exaggeration.
And beyond Kar? I cannot
or literal.
See. I cannot see so far, he says, so yeah, art, bullshit. But once you've crossed the city port of Traps, you'll enter the Backlands. They say that day and night they are controlled by forces other than the sun, and from Kar, too, your progress will be watched. And then we leave.
Wait, there's not like an option like, I don't think you were telling the truth about that telescopic vision thing, confess.
No, sorry.
And there's no option like, oh, you can watch me the entire way, but you can't make sure I have enough food to eat?
Yeah.
There's no agents?
Barely an hour beyond the wall, the air begins to grow foul. The Shamutani hills are infested with the pestilence of the Backlands. It saps the energy from your body, leaving you feel nauseous and weak. Cover my mouth.
We should cover our. I think cover our mouths.
Yeah.
You cover your mouth with your neck scarf, but it does no good. They warned you of this. You'll grow accustomed to it the longer you're out here, but for the moment, you must be very careful. Okay. So now we have more choices on like where to go. So do we want to go? Oops. A low rise or travel cross country? And I'll zoom out a little so you can see.
What is a low rise? Is that something that I'm supposed to know what that means?
This way? Go this way? Or go this way?
Yeah, no, I mean, like, is...
Oh, I think it's, like, a little hill.
Okay, let's go... I think we should do the rise, get above the gross air.
Okay. Yeah, it sounds like a good idea.
Okay. Also, I'm not gonna give you guys hints or anything. This is all you.
Okay, where's our final destination again?
I will show you... It's up.
Okay.
I'll show you when next time we...
So we just went the wrong way? That's what you're telling us?
No.
Well, we're following the road instead of...
look at the village, look for a way around the village, or move on?
I think we should look at the village.
Okay. From this distance, it's hard to make out much about the town, except that it must be desperately poor. The fields on either side are brown caked mud, and the few pen animals are thin and wizened like thirsty vines. No wonder the Sightmaster warriors don't trouble themselves to protect this place. There's nothing here to protect. Do we avoid the village or go inside it?
I think, man, if we go to that village, it'll be a real bummer, I think. it's up to Art.
I think that's a reason to go. I mean, what kind of bummer?
Well, I think that there's going to be a lot of poor people who are starving. I think there might be someone who tries to steal our stuff. but I think
they say we should go around because you'll feel like too enticed to give these poor people our money.
Yes. I want to steer clear of having Kreia be mad at me either choice I make.
Our final destination is Car up here.
Okay.
Which would then start part two of the game. So we probably won't get... We might make it to Car tonight, but we won't play part two tonight.
All right, I think we should go through the village.
Let's go through the village.
Okay.
I think that's technically a good choice.
Of course, if you were scared of a town like Kantapani, then you couldn't hope to survive in Kakabad proper. You follow a path down into town. The round huts are made of a hardback bright clay, and the roofs are thinly thatched. As you pass, eyes appear at dark doorways, tracking your every move. For a moment, it seems like this will be all you see of the town's inhabitants. But then a villager appears from one of the dwellings and blocks your path. Look at him, threaten him, push him out of the way, or cast a spell.
Do we have a spell for this?
I don't think so. I gotta show you guys the spell book, too, next time we're out of the decision-making.
I think we should just look at him, because he's just... All he is standing in the road, right? He's not...
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay, let's just look at him.
Okay. He's 5 feet tall. They can't grow much taller out here in the poison air. He has thick-set arms and thighs and is half-clothed in tattered breeches. His eyes are wide and his long red hair and beard stand out from his face in a wiry tangle. Halt, stranger, he commands. What business have you in Kantapani? I want to buy equipment. Merely passing through. I need directions. I'm hungry and need to eat.
We're merely passing through, right?
I'm a little hungry.
But we have all these rations.
Like, yeah, no, I'm just... I don't know what we should say. I just know that I'm like a little bit hungry.
If there's a free meal in this for you, you want it?
Yeah.
Okay.
Let's just take what we can from these people who live in poison gas.
Well, we're living in the poison gas now, too.
This guy's house is in poison gas.
That's true. Our house is in poison gas because we don't have a house anymore.
I mean, I'm fine with this. I just wanted to be a jerk for a minute.
Yeah, me too.
You'll find the inn in the center of the village. It's run by Amela. There isn't much there, but you'll get something for your belly. Thank him or shove him aside.
Why would we shove him aside?
Because we're aggro.
If you're playing Dark Sun, I guess.
I think we should just thank him. That's what I would do. If the role we're playing is me, I would say thank you.
I think you reply with a slight bow. Enter the inn or pass it by.
That sounds like we'll have to pay for it. Pass it by.
Yeah, we don't actually need any of that stuff.
No, we don't need it. I just thought that maybe they'd be like, oh, I have this apple on me.
Yeah, have a free sandwich. Oh, oops. Nope. See, I messed that up. So I can just rewind it.
Oh, that's nice.
Good, idiot. Yep. Oh. Then you have to make some choices again, but I'll just do the same ones we did. Okay. So yeah, that does come in handy, especially if we die later or something. Okay, so this is our spell book, and you can flip through it, and it'll show you what all the spells do and what they cost.
All right. Oh, these are pretty expensive.
Mm-hmm. And I have them all written down in a notebook next to me, so we don't have to look through this, but I think the art is nice.
You stamina is what you lose after not eating, right?
After not eating or after a battle, yep.
Okay. And after, and a spell costs 3 stamina?
At least some of them do. Not all of them. Like, the one we used to open the gate, that was only 1.
Okay.
So is big, apparently.
Yep, big.
Oh, that says it also requires a gold piece.
Mm-hmm. Yep, some of them require stuff. Some of them don't require any stamina, but just stuff. So those ones are nice. So yeah. So that's a spell book. And then we can look at our inventory right here. We have 6 meals.
A sword. I thought that was a weird B.
What?
It looked like the letter B.
Where?
6.
Oh.
I thought it was a B for a second. Yep. I was like, B meals, what?
Yeah, B meals.
And 14 gold. Okay, so we're passing on by the
That's some tragic music in that
menu. The tavern is not worth your time. It's too poor and meager to offer much hospitality. You head out of Cantapani and along the path into the hills. At the edge of town, you pass a large boulder, and at once, 2 rough-cut villagers spring out with swords drawn. Bandits.
I called it. I knew this would happen if we went into town. Damn it.
Something's going to happen in the woods, too.
Well, yeah, it's a video game. Something happens everywhere, or it'd be boring. Should we reason with them, or should we deal with the curs?
I mean, they're both going to end up with fights, right? We're not giving them the backpack, and they're not going to actually be reasoned with.
They might be able to be reasoned with. Let's try it. We're, like, intimidating.
All right, let's try it. And if you want to rewind, we can rewind, too, if this doesn't turn out good. But we'll see. I don't want any trouble, you declare. The first band edges forward, a sword tickling your chest. Running you through? No trouble at all. The pack.
I think we should defend ourselves.
Yeah, it's probably for
Absolutely.
Us. You've mistaken me for someone else, you declare. I would like to give you a moment to reconsider because I will kill you if I have to. Let's fight. Unless you want to zap them.
We should cast a spell. No, we should make ourselves big.
Okay. Sometimes it won't let you cast certain spells. I don't know why. Okay, yeah, we can't cast big right now.
Okay, well then forget that.
Okay.
Big is the only one that's worth it to cast. Because it's only 1 stamina.
Right,
because
it would make them go away.
Right, and it's only 1 stamina instead of 3. And I trust Kelsey to know how to fight
the people. Oh, thanks.
I mean, to be fair, I don't know if that's a warranted trust, but... Shoot. Sounds like maybe no.
Well, he's half dead.
Okay.
See,
and we're...
He's about to... Yeah.
We're barely even close to dead.
Mm-hmm.
So when would you not want to just be as powerful as you can?
Because if I go all the way up here, it's going to use up all of that, and I'll have to defend for a couple turns to gain that back up.
Okay.
Mm. Okay. So we got him. We lost 2 stamina, and they say decent dueling.
Thank you.
Second bandit takes 1 look at his dead colleague, turns and makes a run for it. Do we chase him or do we let him go?
What do you think? All right, he might have some cool stuff on him. He does it.
Yeah, we should let him go. I don't need him.
Yeah, we don't need that.
Okay. You let him go. He will tell others not to try to interfere with Annalanders in the future. Turning back to the path, you begin walking once more. After about half an hour, the way becomes an uphill incline. Leaving Canatopia behind marks the true start of the wilderness. Beyond that tiny outpost, there are scattered homesteads and Carr, a thriving city port, but all are touched by cruelty, isolation, and fear. The backlands and the long shadow cast by Mampang Forest darken everything. Do we want to reflect about the crown, or is there no time for reflection?
Well, it's a reflect.
Yeah.
I think meditation has a...
With the crown stolen, things can only grow worse. In the long years since Kalana the Reformer founded the Alliance, the crown has been passed from kingdom to kingdom every 4 years, ensuring each kingdom has its turn to lead, but no more. Ruddlestone, have all enjoyed its power. But when the crown came to Annaland, it was stolen by Bergmen from Zaman and carried off to Mampang. See, there's so much fantasy bullshit words in here. With the crown, the Archmage will be unstoppably powerful. There's no chance of sending an army against him. A military force would not survive the journey. So here you are, a lone adventurer, walking the long path to Mampang alone.
Wait, so why do they think that one person has better chance than an army? Is this like X-Wings have to take down the Death Star? Like, is that the...
I guess. I honestly don't know. Maybe we're part of a prophecy.
Unstoppably powerful. There is no chance of sending an army against him. And then a military... I mean, like, a lot of people would probably die in the way, but I think that having that many people around would probably keep you alive.
Even if it was just you and, the, like, 1,000 people, right? It would help.
Right.
Although maybe this 6 food is all the food they have left.
Wait, so what's our character's name again?
We didn't name her.
Okay.
We just picked boy or girl, and I picked girl. That was the only choice I made.
Okay. Because I thought that earlier you called her Annalanders, and then it said that Annaland was the name of the place that we're from.
Yeah, yeah.
Annalanders
is the gossip columnist in the village you started out with. Or the advice columnist. Shit.
The road splits around the base of a giant tree, but does not rejoin on the other side. The left path winds down into a valley. The right rises up a slope toward the first thick forest of the hills. Do you want to look right and left, or do you want to choose without looking?
Well, choosing without looking sounds bad.
Yeah, that's... We're not that... We weren't bored yesterday.
Yeah.
It's hard to see much further uphill. The forest is sudden and thick and the path narrow. It may be hard going in that direction, but the hills will involve a lot of climbing eventually, and you may get a decent view of the next leg from the top of the ridge.
Well, we've got a map, so...
You pause to consider the lower route. There's a river there, and the path follows the left bank. It is a safer route, secluded and protected, but the curve of the landscape would mean you were almost backtracking. You're about to make your choice when you hear a faint cry from somewhere close at hand. Ignore it, look around, or move on from a trap.
I say look on. Look around.
Look around.
Look on. Look on is not... You hear a noise. Do you want to stare into the distance?
You look around and finally up into the branches of the tree. A pair of wizened, calloused feet are dangling down over your head, about to drop on you, perhaps? Do you want to throw something into the tree, say who's there, or climb up?
I think throw something into the tree is the comedy choice.
So is that what you want?
Yes.
All right.
You good with that,
Art? I'm into it.
Okay.
Yeah.
Casting about for a decent-sized rock, you settle on one and then... turn and lob it into the tree. You aim carefully for your target, a wiry old man who looks as thin and bedraggled as a winter shrub. The stone strikes him and he cries out as he almost topples from the branch. Oi, he cries, you almost had me eye out. Apologize, aim better this time, or leave him, he's worthless.
Apologize, he looks weird and therefore powerful.
Yeah, he's basically, yeah, he's like the color green away from being Yoda.
Apologize. I'm sorry, you reply. I thought you were an attacker. Me, he laughs at you. I'd crack me thumb if I tried to squash a woodlouse. Now will you help me down? The slow way, too, if you don't mind. Help him down. What are you hiding from? Or leave him.
What's he hiding from?
Yeah, what are you hiding from, weird old man?
How the old man got up the tree is a puzzle. He must have been escaping someone fearsome to climb so high. What are you hiding from? You cry. Damned elvens, he replies. I were traveling from Dumpus to the outpost settlement in Annaland, but I were waylaid by elvens. Robbed me blind, all but took my eyes and left me up the tree. I keep getting older, you see. We all do, but some worse than others. Climbed up, but now I'm too old to get down. Help him, leave him, or climb up toward him.
Let's help him. Why not?
Help him.
Phoban says, yeah, don't throw another rock or our ass is cursed. Swing yourself onto the lowest branch of the tree. You reach up and grab the old man by the waist. He's light as a leaf. Thanks for that, he remarks, brushing himself down and almost knocking himself over in the process. What will you do now? What do I get in return? Leave and move on.
Let's do that top one. Let's not be presumptuous. If he is a magical being, they hate it when you know that you get a reward.
You good with that, Art?
Yeah.
LWC says, wait, was he too old to get down when he went up there, or has he been up there so long that now he's too old to climb down?
It sounded like they cast like an old man spell on him.
Oh, yeah. That could be.
Oh.
What will you do now, you ask? Keep going for Annaland, he says. That's where I set off from a while back now. You wouldn't believe the story if I told you. Oh, so is this the guy who was going to come back different?
Oh, yeah, sure.
Oh, maybe.
I actually just realized that could be it. Like, I played this
that a sounds pretty bunch. Plausible. No, this is a different Steve Jackson than that Steve Jackson. Though, they might as well be the same.
They share a lot of traits, these Steve Jacksons.
They do.
I'd say they're twins, but you don't name twins the same name.
I have I have a friend whose stepmom and her brother have the same name.
What?
My friend's stepmom and her stepmom's brother have the same name.
What's that name?
It's Ronalda.
There's a man out there named Ronalda?
I think that his name might be Ronaldo, but that's still close. The same name. Yeah. It's just the masculine form of Ronaldo.
Sure.
Do we want?
That's weird, though, right?
Yeah, that's weird.
Anyway, so my point is that Steve Jackson and Steve Jackson might be twins.
Those Jackson people are just... Maybe it's like Steven with a PH and Steven with a V.
Yeah, that's it. Swizzle Malarkey says, this is the weirdest lie. It's not a lie.
So he's giving us a page from a spell book. Do we want to take it, refuse it, or look at it first?
Refuse it. I want to look at it.
Art?
I want to look at it, yeah. Okay.
You look the page over suspiciously. It seems to be half of a spell, CA, that may have been used for pest repulsion, but it is unworkable in its current state. Keep or refuse?
I'm trying to figure out what the end of it is. Pest repulsion.
Cad.
It's caw. Like it's...
Oh, for crows? Caw?
Like it's a crow. Crows eat bugs, right?
Yeah.
I think we should keep it. Why not? What's going to happen? Keith? Did we lose Keith?
Oh, we might have. Well, your decision. Keep it. The man falls quiet and squats down on the ground. With his jabbering done, you hear a buzzing sound from high up in the tree. A beehive. Climb up and investigate, or leave and move on.
Well, if we climb and investigate, we're going to have to cast this spell we don't know the end of. But yeah, I mean, it'll give us a limited number of letters.
True.
I'm back.
Hello.
Hey, we took.
I thought
the
I fixed my internet
spell.
Because it hasn't. My internet hasn't been doing this since the last time that I streamed with Art a few days ago. But yeah, there's something wrong with my Wi-Fi. I don't know. It keeps just disconnecting.
Maybe it's stream related.
Maybe, yeah. Maybe it's like a firewall issue. I don't know.
Maybe it's a California thing.
California.
I don't live there.
Right, but I do. Maybe it's when you're talking to someone from California.
Oh, okay.
Should we climb higher for the beehive, use magic, or give up?
Let's use magic.
Yeah, let's use this new pest spell.
You get your balance enough to free your hands.
Oh, is that what the spell was? It was a pest spell?
Mm-hmm.
Pest control spell.
Why did he think we needed that?
I don't know, but we can't cast it. There's no C.
No C.
Wait, they gave us a pest control spell, and then they showed us a beehive and won't let us use it? I quit.
Yeah. We could probably zap it, but that seems
dramatic. We're not
going to
waste three stamina to zap a beehive. That's just going to make them angry. There's so many. You can't hit all the bees unless you have a spell specifically tailored to bugs.
I don't.
We do now. Not.
Well, we do, but we can't use it.
God. Does it require something that we don't have?
Well, we don't know the last letter.
Oh, we don't? Why not?
Because it's ripped up. It's like half of the page.
Oh, so this old man, we stopped and saved this old man, this creepy old man, and all he gave us was a broken spell?
Yeah.
He's almost as bad as the king that won't feed his soldiers.
Yeah.
Yeah.
This is a world filled with injustice.
It is. It's only going to get worse from here.
Cricket, come here. Come on.
Sorry. So do we want to cast
cat
a
cat is
trying to say hi.
Something else, or leave the spells?
Leave the spell.
Yeah, leave the spell.
I'm not
going
to waste three stamina to get rid of some bees. That's garbage. It's a bad deal.
I think I have to rewind so that we don't have to cast a spell.
Anyway, on that note, I have to leave.
Okay.
All right, see you later. I got to go pick up Gavin from the the movies. He saw Deadpool.
Oh.
I don't know if it went well yet.
Okay. I liked it.
You liked it?
I did.
I heard that it was bad, but then heard that it like wasn't even out yet. And so whoever told me that was a liar. Yeah.
I liked it, but think it's going to be like super overrated. But this is probably a conversation that's a little long for you have to leave right now.
I don't see it in a Metacritic. Oh, no, there it is. Deadpool.
Sorry, I rewound. I messed up the rewinding again. So I'm just replaying this part.
Sure.
Oh, okay, now I'm going. Bye.
Bye. See you later. Keep it. Okay, so do you still want to climb up and investigate?
I probably not, right? We're just going to climb all the way up and then we're going to get stung by a bunch of bees, right?
I don't know.
All right, let's go. Let's go up. Let's go up there.
Okay. Climb higher.
Yeah.
You climb up into the branches. The bees are quick to attack. You can't brush them away as your hands are clinging onto the tree, so you're stung. Looks nasty, the old man remarks. Keep climbing to get it or drop out of the tree.
Yeah, keep climbing. Maybe they have the end of that get rid of bee spell in the hive.
You aren't going to let some bees stop you. You climb higher, getting some more stings before you reach the hive and knock it to the ground. You cut it open and remove a lump of wax and enough honeycomb for one meal. The man wants to know if we want to hear a riddle from the elvens.
Sure, why not?
See him, though he sees you not, a stinging beast in a box not left. To guard a key, it is his lot, to jail a witch of luck bereft. It is nonsense, clearly. You nod once, then turn your attention to the path ahead. Okay, so...
Yeah, it does seem like nonsense.
Do you want to go the low path or the high path? The high path was into the forest. The low path was down by the river.
Right, but it's backtracking.
Mm-hmm.
Our stamina's not great right now, huh?
No, but we're probably going to get to eat soon.
Okay, let's go through the woods then.
Okay.
I ain't afraid of no woods.
The high route seems the most secure. In a valley, you can be easily observed from above and led astray. But out in the hills, you can go whichever way you choose. Of course, when night falls, it might be cold and exposed up on the slopes. But no matter, this journey was never destined to be easy. So you're climbing up in the woods. After an hour's walk, you're starting to feel hungry. Stop and eat or continue walking?
Stop and eat. We're hungry.
You clamber to the top of a low stone dolmen, sit out, and pull out the sugary honeycomb and eat. You feel better for your rest. The climb continues. Do you want to make camp or do you want to keep walking?
How late is it? Is that part of that thing down there?
It says it was twilight.
We should probably make camp. I don't want to walk through the woods in the dark.
That's probably a good idea. Do you want to eat something else or go to sleep?
I don't know. Did that count as eating?
Yeah.
Are we going to like... No.
Okay.
We got places to be.
You lay yourself out on the ground and are quickly asleep. The moon is high and full. There's a pain in your leg.
Oh, great.
Slowly realize what's happening. A giant bat has settled on your chest and is feeding on your leg.
Kill it. Kill it.
Okay. Look, it's so cute. It's like a little unicorn bat.
It's terrifying. What are you even talking about?
Actually. Oh, I could have done that. Nope. Dead.
Yeah.
The bat dead, you toss its carcass back into the woods, and now truly exhausted, you lie back. Phoben says, that looked way more menacing in the original art.
I mean, I think you have to think about it, right? Like, a giant bat sitting on your chest would be terrifying. It would. A giant bat standing in front of you is probably, about knee high.
Once again, the crown fills your dreams. Only now, instead of being hidden away in Mampang Fortress by the Archmage, you see it on the head of the burly villager from Cantapani. Anyone can wear the crown, he declares to you, but wearing the crown, you are no longer just anyone. And then he points a finger at you that seems to crackle with energy. You find yourself drawn toward him, commanded to do his bidding. Suddenly, you're surrounded by angry bees. You're walking towards a crack in the ground. It seems sure to swallow you whole. You stumble at its edge, about to fall. Next morning.
All right.
So our spirit's a fox now because of the choices we've been making.
Right.
And you can pray to your spirit, but the spirits are not generous and they decline to help often. So we should only pray in like a real emergency.
All right. I don't think this is a real emergency.
No. You can feel yourself getting accustomed to the fetid air of these hills. You now ascended several hundred feet and can expect to make excellent progress before the end of the day. As you cross the brow of a hill, you see something that makes you stop in your tracks. To your left is a clearing, and in the clearing are several poles planted firmly in the ground. Atop each pole is a head. Do you want to look at the heads or keep moving?
I mean, yeah, what if these are people we know?
Look at them?
Yeah.
Okay. The heads are of all kinds and ages. Some are recently fixed while others have decayed, and some are nothing but skulls and hair. Human heads, goblin heads, or two heads of creatures you don't recognize all have sewn up eyes and mouths. A large X painted on a nearby rock is obviously intended as a warning not to venture any further. But ahead, the road forks left and right, and you can't be sure which path you're warned not to take. The right-hand path continues to climb, and the left-hand path winds down the side of the hill.
Okay, there's a lot to think about here.
Yes, there is. I zoomed out.
Well, the question is, like, what are they trying to keep me away from?
Mm-hmm.
And I think it's that mine. I think we should go... We should go down.
Okay, so go to cross that bridge.
Yeah, that's what they're trying to keep me away from is that village, in which case they have to have another head display at the other fork path. That just seems like a lot of work.
It does. So left?
Yeah.
All right. After half an hour, you hear the gurgling of a stream, and then quite suddenly you emerge from the trees to the edge of a fast-flowing river. Fording would be impossible, but luckily someone has brought a bridge. Test it, cross, or turn back.
I mean, I want to say that I think testing a bridge is silly, but we should probably do it, right? My gut says cross, but my head says test it.
Okay. It's made from stout ropes with thinner strings hanging from them, boards tied to strings. You test the ropes and notice that the left one feels weak. That doesn't mean the bridge is necessarily a trap, although it might be, but it does mean that if this bridge collapses, the left side will fall away first.
Okay. That feels like good information. Let's cross that bridge.
Logic Gate says, obligatory cock yourself and float across joke from Oregon Trail. You begin to make your way carefully across, but at the halfway mark, the boards start to creak and come loose, and then one of the ropes holding the bridge up unlashes itself completely, and you're plunging into the water. Race for the other bank or try to fall well.
Why did I test this if it wasn't going to help me?
This game is mean.
Halfway, it doesn't sound like, we can make it, but I also don't want to fall into this river.
Right.
Let's go for it. Race to the other bank.
You make a break for the far bank, pounding across the boards as they tumble and plunge into the rapid water. At the last minute, the bridge dissolves. You must jump. Left or right?
Jump right, because the left side's going to fall away first.
You leap right, but as the bridge breaks and twists, the boards rise up on that side and catch you in midair, winding you. You grab one of the ropes to help you slow your fall. You're dumped in the water without too much injury. Whew. So, we just lost all our food.
Great.
Because that got ruined. There's no turning back now, unless we rewound. Something moves in the bushes nearby. Investigate or ignore it.
Does that mean we should have jumped left? Did I?
No, I think important. I don't know. I think you were.
Let's investigate it.
Okay. Crossbow Flex says, I like that. Try to not fall like a total dweeb was pretty much an option there. Who's there? You demand as you approach the bush, peering through either side to spot if the figure tries to run. When you get there, you find nothing. Do you want to beat the bush or leave it?
I don't know, those both feel like silly options. I'm not going to sit here and beat up shrubbery. I am a dignified...
I am the chosen man. One.
beat the bushes, why not?
Okay. You find nothing except for one thing, a hollow tube of bamboo that looks like a blowpipe. It's cracked and may have been discarded as worthless by its owner, but this might mean that whoever put the heads on the poles is nearby. You toss the pipe away, but you would best be on your guard.
Oh, huh.
Follow the path or through the trees?
See, I was really hoping that village was going to have some food for us to replace that other food.
Yeah.
I guess we should go through the trees. I was too dignified for that earlier, but look where it got me.
So you want to... skip over that village?
Yeah.
Okay. Did you? If headhunters are about with blowpipes, you want to stay well clear. You walk for a few hours through light forest dappled with sun until you're climbing the side of a steep bridge. Keep climbing. The path climbs again up a low hill covered with thick branches and shrubs that snag at your clothing. Halfway up, you hear a sound, twigs breaking. Freeze or keep walking?
Freeze. Just hit right with a blow dart.
Freeze is a large creature the size of a bear emerges directly in front of you. It has black and white fur and a long, bushy tail. That's kind of cute. Do you want to prepare to attack or try to edge around it?
Try to edge around it. I got no quarrel with this giant cat.
leaving the main trail, you slip through the shrubs around the creature. Its patch is clearly the square of dirt through which the path leads. It watches you to ensure you don't come too close, but it doesn't attack. You did it.
Hey.
Good job. Approach Christatani. The sun is just now past its zenith, and everywhere a dusty heat rises from the baked earth. Do you want to move on from the village or look at it?
Look at it. We need food, and these devil people should have some.
The houses are well set. There's more than just one street running through the center of town. It's though this place, though once rich, has had its heart scooped away. Empty, abandoned houses. So you want to enter instead of avoiding?
I mean, yes, but I acknowledge that it's a bad idea.
Here we go. Look at the people or ignore them?
Look at them. We're going to need food.
Their own attire is rough by comparison to your gear. They wear their hair long piled up on their heads. These people are ghastly poor. The village is like a ghost town here on the knife edge of the backlands. Talk in the alehouse or rest at an inn?
Talk in an alehouse. Or man of the people. Enemy of the state.
Several hill dwellers are here talking gruffly. When you enter, they watch you with understandable caution. The owner of the hut comes over to you. Welcome to Christatani, he declares. What do you want? Greet him or ignore him and sit with the hill dwellers.
Greet him. What are we? An uncouth jerk?
An evening's rest and a drink to wet my throat, you reply. Ale's one gold piece, he answers. Please sit. Do you want to sit with the oldest man or the youngest man?
What a weird choice.
All these life or death choices and then who you want to socialize with.
Yeah, but I don't even know how to begin to make this choice. the oldest.
Okay. Greetings, old man, or what are you looking at?
Greetings, old man. Civility, please.
Stranger, his face is gravelly like the dusty dirt that lines the streets of his town. Where are you from? I come from Annaland. It doesn't matter. Don't answer him.
We're logic gate is right. We're an ape now. That happen? I come from Annaland. Well, I'm not.
Not as many cross through the Canatopi gate in either direction, if you know what I'm saying. I understand you, or Annaland must be kept safe.
I understand you. I don't need to be like, you're all dangerous, that's why.
They say there's a war coming, something to do with a crown. Not if I can help it, I seek that crown, or a crown?
Not if I can help it. No one likes war, least of all old people. I guess old people like war the most, actually. Old people don't fight wars.
Is that so, replies the man. Well, seems like you should be drinking on the house tonight for the good of us all. Chanty, he calls the innkeeper over. I'll cover this lady's ale. I buy my own drinks or it's appreciated.
Alright, there's like... What's the chance this guy's gonna drug us and kill us? Low, right? Or like, even if he does, it's gonna happen anyway. Yeah, sure, it's appreciated. We gotta save somebody to buy some more food.
You sip your beer. Do you want to talk to the young man that's with the older man, or do you want to ask the old man about the area?
Let's talk to the young man.
You thank him for the conversation. You catch the young man's eye. He moves over to be right beside you, close enough to whisper in your ear, but you don't quite catch what he says. Repeat that or move away.
Repeat that?
The man giggles to himself unexpectedly. Leaning in again, so close you can smell the fumes on his breath, he declares, "Snatticats." Then he collapses in a fit of giggles once more. Whatever the joke is, you don't get it. What do you mean, or tell me about the village?
Tell me about the village.
Snatticats. The man nods twice, then drinks deeply from his beer to wet his throat. Or perhaps not. Because as he puts the mug down once more, he says nothing, just fidgets with his fingers and occasionally grins in your direction. What's wrong with you, or ask one of the other dwellers about this man?
Ask someone else. This guy's weird.
What's wrong with this man, you demand? She shrugs, frees you from your grasp. Every village has one, she answers. Doesn't mean we're all like that. Good stock we are, and she flutters her eyelids. You get back to your feet. The young man giggles to himself, but does not attempt to stop you.
I guess that's our choice.
Okie dokie.
Hey, we got a ration.
We did. He grabs your... The old man gave us a bomba fruit.
Great.
Let's look at it. Oh, I should... it's thick rinded fruit that keeps well and be highly nourishing when you decide to eat it. Its only drawback is its incredible weight. It's now evening and time to sleep. Logic 8 says, we invite you to discuss these events on social media using the hashtag Snatacats.
Find it in. These people have all been pretty nice friendly to me, except that weird Snatacats guy.
Are you from the king, she demands? No, I'm a mere traveler, or I'm on a mission for the king.
Let's be honest. We're on a mission for the king.
Taxes, she replies quickly.
No. What? No.
This is a guest house, the best in Cristatani. Only guests stay, and any guest of mine knows it costs me 3 gold pieces to host a traveler overnight and 2 to feed them, but it's all between friends. Take a room, eat first, go elsewhere.
We should do both, right? We should eat and sleep here.
Okay. So let's eat first. Oh boy, skunk bear stew. It is thick as mud and has a rich, disgusting flavor.
That's better than a thin, disgusting flavor, you know? You wanna...
I guess.
Yeah, we'll take the room. Right?
Yeah. There are 3 other guests already staying and asleep, so you settle quickly. The bed's not clean, but it's comfortable. Our stamina is full. We have vivid dreams of walking endlessly, the hills moving up and down under our feet like a rippling sea. That sounds awful.
Yeah. All these dreams are just what happened to us.
Yeah. Yep. The food in our bag is rotting, wet through. Deep voices booming with laughter. The long, cruel fingers of one hand are curled around the metal frame of a crown. Chase Neckbeard says, Snatacats is fuckboy code for crown. You wake early, sit for a moment. You're in no great hurry. The muscles in your legs are feeling lean and strong from so much walking. Surrounded by several miles of fields, it sits in a well-protected ring of hills and is close enough to the river to be reasonably prosperous. As you follow the path between lines of sun-baked crops, you come to a fork in the road. The right-hand way leads past a set of outbuildings, while the left heads directly off into deep woodland.
Between the buildings.
Okay. You see a blind beggar sheltering the shade. Alms, would you, for love of sin, let alms? Look at him, throw him a coin. I have none to give. Walk on by.
Throw him a coin. We're friend of the people.
You're a kind traveler, the beggar says. He feels over the surface of the coin, then bites down on it. Why me? This is a gold piece. You're too generous to a poor sightless beggar. You'll get me killed if anyone knows that I have it. The beggar beams up at you. Look after yourself or it won't last.
Look after yourself. It apparently sucks around here.
Wait, he calls. One moment, please. He begins to scrabble around, feeling over his body as if looking for holes. Eventually he cries, aha, and pulls out a copper key, which he holds out to you. Take it. What is that?
Take it.
Years ago, I lived in Carr, he explains. Carr was my home, and in the city port, I watched over prisoners in the jail. Beware the red eyes in Carr, or my fate will befall you, and you'll be here with me, begging for your living. What are the red eyes? Thank you for the advice. What's this key?
What are the red eyes?
Pray you never find out, is a simple reply. Listen to me. Carr is wary of strangers, but this key will help you if you be captured by red eyes. Trust old me. Logic 8. Points out that we've been upgraded from an ape to a gorilla.
Is that an upgrade?
I think so. An ape is smaller and gorillas are like giant apes. And I think I don't know what the smartness level is. Ape is kind of generic.
Was ape an upgrade from fox?
I think that's like a lateral move, I think.
All right.
You could continue straight on and upwards or turn west for a while.
So go straight. I ain't afraid no ruins.
The place you're walking through seems thick with desolation, as if it was long ago abandoned. Then, as if to confirm your thought, you come across two enormous stone pillars listing slightly to either side of the road. They form a gate, but the gate is three times the height of a man. Look them over.
Look them over.
In an old script, L and K, the remnant of a spell of fortune, perhaps, or of binding for these now fallen stones.
It's probably L-O-K, right? For, like, lock?
Probably.
Okay.
Go through?
Go
back. Okay, go through?
Yeah.
There's nothing for it but to go forward. Centuries ago, this must have been a palace of a king 12 feet tall. Now it's been leveled and the stones stolen for the field walls and foundations of villages all around. Investigate the ruins or continue climbing?
Investigate the ruins. I mean, it seems like a little bit of a waste of time, but maybe there's something cool in here. Or maybe a giant's about to kill us.
Follow the street, look inside a house, go back to the path.
Look inside a house?
Search in the grass, follow the street down, head back to the path.
Search in the grass, maybe there's some food. Some old food.
Your hand closes on a clay pot near one wall. It's shaped like a wine jug, but about three times the usual size. Around the neck is a red stain. Wine or maybe blood, it's impossible to tell. The base of the pot has been smashed away, perhaps by age, perhaps by someone unhappy with the contents. You leave the pot behind.
I don't think it is impossible to tell wine from blood.
Yeah, I don't think so either. Because blood would stain, like, dark brown.
Yeah, there's no iron in wine.
Right. Except for that band. Sorry.
I guess we're going to follow the street.
You follow the line of the street down the slope of the hill. The further you go from the path, the more overgrown the ruins become until you can barely make out their outlines at all. You approach the edge of a thick woodland. Do you want to enter the tree line or turn back and climb?
Turn back and climb. I have no interest in going in those woods. They keep trying to make me go in those woods. I don't want to do it.
After a while, you see two cave mouths, one to the left of the path and another to the right.
Oh, why don't we just go... Oh, we can't just carry on.
Yeah. I've actually never done this part. So I don't know.
I mean, I wanted to just carry on, but if you've ever been up here and you want to go in a cave, nope. We can talk about it.
Nope.
Yeah, I have no interest in these caves.
Okay. Carry on. You press on past the caves, not wanting to be distracted from your path. Should we look in as we pass or keep our head down?
Yeah, I mean, if there's a gorgon in there or something, we're pretty boned, but...
So look at it?
Yeah.
You glance into the cave as you pass, but see nothing. While your gaze is turned from the path, you don't notice a small twig until you step on it and it snaps. The sound is small, but it seems to echo between the high stone walls on either hand. Then it's met by a louder noise, the sound of something moving inside the cave to your right. Something's coming. Run for it or stand to my ground?
Run for it?
You turn and race from the mouth of the cave. Something erupts from behind you, roaring and hollering, and you're glad to leave it behind. You hurry out of the shadow of the pass.
Now we're a baboon.
Yeah, we are. That I think that's definitely a downgrade. Approaching Dumpus.
Great.
Enter or avoid?
I don't think we need to go to Dumpus. I think we can avoid Dumpus.
Okie dokie. Kestrel Pie says, the sheer heroism on display here is astonishing. This is self-preservation.
There's nothing heroic about going through and hurting things, living in caves. They just want to live their life up there. They're not involved with this.
You follow the path halfway down in the valley, then stride off across the plain. Close by the village, you find a small patch of trees to offer some shelter. The ancient giant gate is just within view, looming over everything in sight, and from here you can see another village atop a mountain to the west, but not for today. Make camp or continue walking?
Make camp.
Logic Gate points out that Rafiki is a baboon, which Rafiki is pretty cool. Should we eat our fruit before we go to sleep?
Yeah.
Something's pacing outside your hiding place. Peer out or stay put? Or stay hidden?
Peer out.
It's a werewolf.
Oh.
Fight, cast a spell, wait to see what it does.
Wait to see what it does. It's going to attack us.
Kestrel Pie says, such stories for the grandkids as that time I ran away from the thing that was maybe a squirrel. It said that it was huge. It was not a squirrel unless it was like a giant mutant squirrel.
It also said it was hollering, which is well outside the vocal range of a squirrel. I don't know. Do you think we could fight this thing?
Yeah, I think we'll be fine.
Yeah, let's fight this thing.
Okay. Oh, good. Good, right out of the gate. Oh, shoot. Oof. Okay. You crawl back in horror, a werewolf's bite. It does not mean you're cursed yet, but every time it tastes your blood, the chance that you will lose your soul grows higher. No pressure. Really? Fine, I will just... The wolf grows weaker, its eyes grow redder and fierce. For a moment you see there the understanding that one of you will die out here tonight. Not gonna be us. It's tensing, preparing to pounce. I'm gonna defend because I don't know how strong it's gonna be. Yeah, that was a good idea. Werewolf. Yeah. Oos! Got it.
Good work.
Oh, that was close. And we are not cursed with werewolfness. I didn't know that could happen.
And we're back to being a gorilla. Or we're back down to being a gorilla. Whatever this hierarchy is.
Here's our dreams tonight. You wander through doors and hallways built 10, 20 times your height. You're an insect and the hills over which you walk are the follicles of hair on the shaved chin of a giant. Storms of hot, fetid breath sweep over you, threatening to blow you down into hell. Overhead, you fancy you hear the clap of giant wings. The birdmen came for the crown. Perhaps before this journey is finished, they will come for you.
Logic Gate says more like a lycanthrope, am I right? And good work.
Okay, should we go to Urustanti or should we avoid that village?
No, we need to go to a village. We need food.
Okay. When finally you reach the summit and can look out over the low plateau you have crested, you see the path runs through a small settlement of crudely fashioned huts. There are villagers out in the street talking and working. It seems a happy, bustling place. Approach or watch? Kestrel Pie says, also, your finals are coming up and you haven't been studying. Approach?
Yeah.
There seems no obvious danger. You approach along the path until you're close enough for the villagers to notice you. The effect is immediate. They begin to scurry inside their huts as if you're an army and not a lone traveler. You can't help but notice what a sorry bunch they are. Squat, short, all limping strangely. Their bodies are thin and malnourished, and as they disappear through the doors, you notice some missing limbs. Stop at a door and knock, or walk straight through?
I mean, there's probably not going to be food here for us. We can just keep going. If they don't want anything to do with us, I don't need to bother them.
Something about it gives you the shivers.
Oh, we're down to a baboon now. I was apparently the wrong choice. That was a baboon choice.
Enter a hut or leave?
Why would we enter a hut? No, that wasn't...
Oh, did you not want to?
I said, like, why would we? But yeah, what happens? Oh, it's fine. Let's see what happens here.
Okay, sorry.
No, it's...
Hold out a hand of... Okay. The hovel's tiny and poor with no furnishing. The woman lifts a shaking hand as if to hold you back. A family of three cowers from you. Hold out a hand of friendship, cast a spell, or leave this place.
Hold out a hand of friendship?
Are you magical, stranger? Are you not afraid of us? Afraid of you never, or afraid why?
Afraid why?
Don't you know we have the plague in this village? You spring back from him, but it's too late. You can feel the infection on the palm of your hand like a curse. Why didn't you warn me? Curse you, or is there a cure?
Is there a cure?
Some say to drink the juice of the blimberry, but we've all tried so much that no berries grow around the village anymore. And we're still alive, I suppose, but we're not well. You take another step back in fear and regret. You have but a few days. Use magic or leave them.
Oh, boy. Leave them? I guess?
Fear overtakes you and you race out of the door and do not stop running until you are clear of the accursed village.
Wow, we really fucked that one up.
We can rewind or we can keep going.
I mean, it's fine, right? We're not going to die of this curse during this stream, and then we'll,
Yeah, let's just keep going.
Yeah. Maybe we could pray to our baboon god.
True, we could. Look around at this summit, or keep going?
Look around, why not?
Ahead down a steep slope, the next village is sprawled out before you, and even from here you can catch the sound of merry voices and shouting from the streets. It must be a carnival. You're feeling cold. Purple blotches are breaking out on the backs of your hands. Pray for healing or walk on?
Pray for healing. You owe us, baboon god.
You drop to your knees, shivering and shaking, a mouth fervent prayer to your spirit, the baboon. Does it hear you? It's hard to tell. But then you feel warmth creeping through your bones and purple marks on your skin are fading away. You're cured. You raise a cheer for the spirit for such aid. But what about the people you've left behind? They have no such guardian. You follow the track down a steep decline. Umby says, would you like to keep your plague? YM.
Yeah, well.
All right. Head for the town.
I don't remember telling those people they couldn't pray for.
That's true.
To the baboon spirit.
Should we approach this village?
Yeah, whatever. Sure.
Your heart swells. A village might mean a chance to stock your provisions. You hop down from the boulder and make your way forward when an overhanging branch touches your face and you hear a lively chirping. Freeze, turn around, keep going.
Chirping?
Chirp.
Freeze? What is this? Freeze, yeah. Okay. Whatever.
Hovering by your shoulder is a small creature the size of a bird. It is childlike but very thin with green skin, and it flits around you on transparent wings. Oh, the stream is skipping? Let me see. It looks okay. Let me know if it keeps happening. Um, It's childlike but very thin, green skin, flits around on transparent wings. It seems friendly enough. It lands on your shoulder. Talk to it, shake it loose, cast a spell, carry on, it's no threat.
Talk to it?
Greetings, little creature, and hello to you, the creature replies, chirping. My name is Yan. What are you? What do you want with me?
What kind of magic disease do you have? What are you?
The creature does a backflip and gives a low bow. I'm a mini mite. Pleased to meet you. It reaches out a tiny hand and shakes your earlobe. I'm not going anywhere till you've gone. What can you tell me about the village? What do you want with me?
What can you tell me? Where? What can you tell me about the village?
That's Biritani, and it's very safe. It's the largest village in the whole of the Shamuktani Hills. Every traveler who comes this way spends at least one night there, so it's a little bit expensive, especially for mini mites, but pleasant enough. Come on, let's get going, can't we? I'm not going anywhere till you've gone. Let's get going then. What do you want with me?
Maybe what do you want with me? It's a little rude, but I want to know.
See that village, the creature replies. Last time I tried to go through, they told me I wasn't welcome, so I wouldn't mind some protection. Let's get going then. I can protect you. Where I'm going is dangerous. I'm not going anywhere till you've gone.
Where I'm going is dangerous?
You might be killed traveling with me. The creature shrugs. I've got small wings. Can't get far on my own. You're not in any hurry, are you? It observes. Do you want to sleep out in the rough?
Let's get going then.
The creature shakes you by the ear in excitement, and you set off along the path once more. Enter the town or sleep outside?
Enter the town. We need food.
See, I told you it was a happy place. The sounds of festivities grow louder. Jan, what's going on, or keep going?
Jan, what's going on?
Are they bewitched? No, if there was magic, believe me, I know. This is the Festival of the Young. What's that? Enter the festival or avoid it.
What's that? I want to know all the festivals.
The idea is that once a year, the children are allowed the freedom of the village. It's a time of great fun and lots of pranks. You pass the first few buildings where you find a number of children sitting in the street and drinking ale from deep mugs. Further on, a young boy is holding an old woman over his knee and spanking her. On the other side of the street, a group of boys is fighting outside a hut with a sign that reads, Glandragger's Tavern. It's complete mayhem. Do we rescue or leave the old woman?
I mean, this is their tradition, right? I don't want to be, like, showing up and ruining Christmas.
How do you do, fellow kids? Like, like that?
Yeah.
Umby says, dang millennials, and Chase Nightbeard says, ugh, damn kids.
Yeah, leave her. I don't want to mess with these people's thing.
You consider helping the woman, but there's nothing you can do. It is their festival, after all. Enter the tavern or go further into town?
I want to enter the tavern to be full of weird, drunk children.
Sorry.
It's fine. Let's see what the weird, drunk children are doing.
I thought you said I want to. Greetings, stranger. I'm Glandragor. Can I be helping you? Greetings. How much is ale? Leave.
Greetings.
Logic 8 says this beats the last town's traditional celebration of having the plague.
Yeah.
Sorry, would you say greetings or how much?
Greetings, yeah.
I've come a long way. I'm sure you have. Take a seat.
How much is ale? I'm really not interested in drinking.
2 gold pieces, and it's the finest in town. Well, it's the only ale in town. I make sure of that.
I mean, sure. Why not? We're definitely starving to death at one point here. Why not?
It's warm, frothy, and deeply refreshing. You look like you've been on the road a while. You have no idea. Tell me about the village, tell me about yourself, or leave.
Tell me about this village.
Not much to say. What you see is what you get. This place keeps going because it's on the only route between Kar and Cantapani. If one of these mountains falls or the river freezes over, then this place will be a desert in 2 weeks.
I'm headed to Car myself.
Of course you are, he grins. Didn't I just tell you that?
What can you tell me about it?
Car. I loved a girl in Car once. It's the town for love, you know. You have to live every day like it's your last in Car, because the chances are high that it will be. Now there's a city of thieves if ever there was one.
I could watch my back.
Well, don't forget to watch your front as well. They'll come at you whichever way. You'll be passing through Torapani, I suppose. The Svins in Torapani are normally a merry lot, but they're pretty depressed at the moment. There's a real gloom about the place.
What's the matter with them?
Oh, well. I'm sure it's nothing to concern you.
Hmm. What's... okay.
Do we want to abandon Jan or wake him up?
Oh, wake him up!
You poke the little creature who clambers boozily up your finger and then topples off and onto the floor. Leave him there if you like. I'll pick him up and put him in a mug. I love you, he whispers into your ear.
Aww. Aww.
Go further into town or leave town?
Further into town, why not?
Umby says hashtag just plague things. You head out of the tavern and turn a corner to find a group of girls standing by a signpost pointing to the crystal waterfall.
Ask them about the waterfall.
They're too distracted by Jan. Come back. Sure. The water is good for you. Move on. Should we visit the waterfall, find an inn, or leave town?
Let's visit the waterfall.
There's only one path to reach it, winding up the rock face. It passes by a small hut where a ruffian is collecting money. Greet the ruffian, turn back, ask Jan to scout ahead. Or cast a spell.
Ask Jan to scout ahead.
Why don't you scout ahead? Find out if the waterfall is worth the money. Alright, I'll be quick. Don't think you can get rid of me just like that. I can catch up.
Oh, we don't just get to, like, wait?
I know. That's weird.
Greet the ruffian, I guess.
3 gold pieces. It doesn't look like much to me, Jan whispers. I think you'd be wasting your gold if you paid. Pay, haggle, turn back.
Turn back.
For a bath, that's too much. The waters are healing. They'll do more than make you clean.
I don't care.
Go.
Yeah.
You must think me a fool, you reply. The waterfall may be beautiful, but it's not worth risking your gold. As you pass the girls, they sneer. She doesn't smell any better. Ouch.
Yeah. Let's fight them. Great. Let's fight those girls.
I'm a hero. Find it in or sleep outside.
Find it in? We need a meal.
Yeah, we can't live on booze alone.
As much as I'm trying.
A meal, a bed, room, and board.
Maybe just a meal and then sleep out of town, where we are running low on cash here.
4 gold pieces. No discounts. It's steep, but you haven't eaten today and your stomach is churning.
That's like all our money.
It is.
How far are we from where we're going?
We still have a little ways.
How much for a room?
5.
Is that like a package deal?
5 gold pieces.
Get out of here. We can go hungry for one day.
Okay. That's too much. You run a lowly inn, not a palace. Jan hops up and down. Just you and me, then. Be quiet, you grumble. Vorpalfem says, I love how Art tactically handles bathing, but is Keith going to be back anytime soon? Because he would argue for cleanliness. You're tired enough to fall asleep, but you're hungry from not having eaten.
Yeah, well.
Uh-oh. A wolfhound. Fight the beast, cast a spell, throw something at the creature, or hide.
Yeah, that's hide's not going to work. Let's fight it.
Yes.
Is this another werewolf?
It's a wolf hound?
It's the same picture.
It is. Yeah. Dead.
Oh.
Oh, you plunge your blade between its teeth all the way down to its heart. I'm a badass. I hate that we get attacked every time we try to go to sleep. Swizzle Malarkey says, eat the wolf.
Yeah, it's a good idea.
Your dreams are full of plague victims, their faces raw with boils and streaming sores. If all goes well, you'll reach Torapani today, the last village in the hills. Choose a path or ask Jan his advice.
Ask Jan his advice.
To the right is a forest. To the left, the going is easier. The path heads through a field of black flowers to Torapani. Choose a path. What else do you know?
What else does he know?
Nothing, protests the creature, and that's a fine way to talk to your guide. I'm not charging you for my advice, you know. You'll get no more from the creature. Time to decide. A field of black flowers or the forest? Logic Gate says we've become an elephant.
Oh. Is that better or worse than a baboon?
Logic Gate says I think that's an upgrade. I would also think that's an upgrade. Elephants are really cool.
Left.
Okie dokie. A powerful, pleasant smell reaches your nostrils, and you see off to your right a path through a field of beautiful black flowers. Ask Jan about it, turn back and go the other way, go on through the field.
Ask Jan about it. This feels like that scene in Wizard of Oz.
Mm-hmm. Jan, what are those flowers? Who knows, who cares, chirps the Mimite, dancing about on your shoulder impatiently. This is the shortest path to Torapani. Do you want to get there or not? Magic, go back, go through the field.
Can we see what magic we have access to here?
Mm-hmm. I'll see what I can find out for myself. Good luck with that, Jan replies. You clear your mind, trying to ignore the smell rising from the field and ready a spell. Let me look at my spell thingy. Where did it go? Or we could just do it like this. Click random letters and then see what the spell is. Huff would create a wind, but we don't have a gale horn.
Sure.
M-A. Mag would protect from magic. Requires one stamina.
I mean, that doesn't sound like a terrible idea.
Should we do that?
Yeah.
You weave the spell, but although you feel yourself weakened, nothing happens. Jan shakes his head. Very sorry to have to tell you this, but there's no point in trying your magic lime around. I'm afraid mimites and magic don't mix.
Oh. Well, so, this guy's gotten a little more useless.
Something he could have mentioned to us before.
I feel like we should probably turn back. It's okay. Probably bad news in there.
There's something about the flowers that makes you uneasy. We're going the other way, you tell Jan, turning back and heading downhill. The mini-mite complains, but does not leave your shoulder. Suddenly, Jan falls quiet and hisses in your ear. Stop now. Why? Okay.
Stop, but say nothing.
Yana's... You come to a dead stop. Yana's right. Something is moving through the trees toward you. A moment later, a point of steel has emerged from the darkness between two trees and touches your neck. You've seen me, whispers a voice. I know it. Look into the darkness. Answer, draw my sword.
Answer.
I see nothing, you call back. You're quite safe. It is not I who is not safe, returns the voice. Prepare to fight. Ask who's there.
Ask who's there.
Logic Gate says, pretty things? Ugh, let's go to the spooky forest.
I've seen the Wizard of Oz. Those flowers were bad news.
Yeah, that is true. Head to toe in black. Had you not seen him a moment before? Sharp scimitar. Fight him or cast a spell.
Oh, we can't cast the spell. We gotta fight him.
Oh, that's right. All right, here goes nothing. He only has 8 stamina, we have 18. We're definitely going to win this.
We only have 14.
Oh, yeah. True. Oh, shit. I jinxed it. My duty is to sever your head from your neck, he tells you. You will not hold me from it. Alright, one more hit, and we'll be good. Woo, did it. I am not so proud as to not admit when I'm beaten, he groans. You may finish me if you so choose, but if you do, do me an honor and use my own blade. The assassin's not dead, but lies on the floor gasping. Finish him and search his body, or spare him.
Finish him and search his body. I'm not doing business with assassins.
You rifle his body for a measly 3 gold pieces, then continue on the path out of the woods and onto a dusty hillside. Jan, for a brief while, says nothing. Perhaps he's shocked. How much longer do you think we'll be traveling today? I'm hungry and tired. We've gone such a long way. You can stop here, not much farther. Be silent.
You can stop here. What do I? I'm not anti-magic weirdo.
You'd like that. I'm sure you would. You continue along the path and around the side of a hill. There's an old woman sitting on the front step. A river seems to emerge from beneath her. As you get closer, you realize the water flows underneath her house. The house itself is set. And its blade struts like an insect straddling the water course. Do we greet the woman or try to creep past?
Greet the woman. She's an old lady with a river house. She's not a...
Come over here, won't you?
This is a trap.
I can barely see you.
This is a wolf wearing an old lady suit.
Walk past the house or approach?
Approach. We're in it.
Please, she beckons. I get so lonely living out here on my own, away from the villages. Go inside or stay outside.
Stay outside.
I shouldn't stay too long. I have a long journey still to make. So, of course, she replies. We'll have tea out here on the step. Watch it, Jan whispers in your ear. I don't trust this one. Drink the tea or make conversation.
Make conversation.
Umbi says she looks creepy. Umbi says she's clearly a werewolf. The tea is still hot. You cup it between your hands as you speak. What small talk do you want to make?
What's your name? I want to know the name of the lady who poisons us and kills us in this hut.
They call me Gazamun, she replies with a smile. I used to be quite well known in my way. You nod, but you've never heard of her. Why do you live alone? This is a beautiful place. Drink the tea.
This is a beautiful place.
This is the top of the crystal waterfall, she says. The river runs right under my house. They say it carries all my goodness and youth away while I sleep, and the villagers bathe in it for luck. I'm sure it isn't quite true. So the malarkey says, eat the lady!
I mean, why do you live alone?
It must be more dangerous. Oh, she smiles sweetly. No one bothers about me. Why would they? You make to sip your tea when the old woman stops you, catching your arm before the cup reaches your lips. Oh, she says suddenly, I've forgotten the pot. Drink my tea, switch cups with her, and make a run for it.
What? What is she talking about? Switch cups with her. Let's Princess Bride this.
When she returns, you lift the one closest to you and drink. A sudden deep pain grips your stomach and you double over. What's happening? Ho, suspicious stranger, laughs Solomon. I can count on travelers suspecting my witchcraft. I'll kill you or please release me.
Please release me.
You try to shout, but you're paralyzed and quite powerless. The old woman begins to search through your bag. With a coup of delight, she pulls out the spellbook page you were given by the old man in the tree. My book, she cries. The missing page. Why didn't you tell me you had my missing spell? She scurries off into the kitchen and returns with a cup of liquid, which she pours into your half-open mouth while clucking and stroking your head. It is an antidote, and you feel your body slowly unfreeze. What is the spell? Who is the old man?
Who was that old man?
A rogue and a bandit, she replies, spitting. 4 days ago, I was visited by a traveler such as yourself. But when I was away making my tea, as I always do, he started leaping through my book and tore out a page. He must have been a wizard of power, because he vanished almost too fast for me to curse him. What curse did you cast? Will you uncurse him now?
What curse did she cast? What was up with that guy?
Well, you saw him, she replies. I aged him. Didn't stop him escaping, though. She fusses with the page, repairing your spellbook with some gentle magic. Shall I show you how useful the spell is, she says. Please, what do you mean, no?
Please.
My pleasure. Jan begins to squeal and screech and makes some awful noises about what he'll do if he ever catches up with you again, but doesn't stop the old lady from casting her spell. The mini-mite vanishes. You feel a flow of magic back through your body. Thank you, where is he?
Where is he?
Is he dead? The old woman shakes her head. Oh no, but with any luck you won't see him again. You nod at that, get to your feet once more.
Great.
Okie dokie. Below you is the village of Torpani, slung from one side of the valley to the next like a flood barrier. Observe it or approach.
Observe it.
A village of the Svin, an aggressive-looking race of man-orcs. You might expect their village to be rowdy, but it seems strangely quiet. Still, there's no way around it. You'll have to go through.
All right.
You enter the village. There's a definite air of depression hanging over the place. The Svins are going about their business slowly and miserably and pay you no heed. You sit yourself down on a tree stump in the very center of the village to consider your options. Find an inn to rest, make contact with the villagers first. Logic Gate points out a lot of good that anti-magic ability did Jan.
Yeah, apparently it'll only protect them from our...
Yeah.
Make contact with the villagers first. We're sociable people. It doesn't work out for us, but...
They're discussing a friend apparently killed in the night by an assassin's curved blade. I met this assassin? Is that why you're all afraid?
I met this assassin. Maybe we can get some cred here.
You met him? You're still alive. I killed him, or I spared him.
We killed him.
You do good, but you one day late for us. But with Esh dead, who saved Tia? Who is Tia? Who was Esh?
Yeah, who is Tia?
Our flower. The Svin who answers wipes a tear from the corner of his eye, scratching himself painfully with an uncut fingernail. Tia is Chief's daughter, the other Svin says. Esh was to save her. Now Esh not alive, so Tia is soon not alive. What happened to her? I'll save her. You need a new hero. Sir 235. What happened to her? Sir 235 says, time to become the hero of the town.
I mean, maybe.
Goblins, they sacrifice. Sacrifice? He's unsure of the word, so mimes a gesture like a stabbing downwards knife blade. Yes, sacrifice to great cave demon. Trouble is, another says, our village die if chief line end, Tia is end. So if end ends, we end. All very sad. Very sad, they all agree. Who you? One asks suddenly, as if only just thinking of it. He prods you in the chest. Warrior, sorcerer, traveler.
I mean, I'm willing to trade some... I guess warrior.
Warrior? Great warrior? The greatest, or I do my best?
Do my best? We're okay.
We're all right. Best is good. Meek Tifa, he signals to the others. We take to chief. Where are you taking me? Wait to see what happens. Pray.
Wait to see what happens. I need to pray right now.
Several spins watch from doorways. A few murmur blessings or maybe curses as you pass. You reach a low hut on the edge of the village. You're set down carefully. Captured. The door is slammed and locked. A moment later, it reopens and your possessions are thrown inside. Wait or try to sleep?
Wait.
You pull your knees up to your chest and wait. The long watches of the night pass slowly, and in the end, nothing happens and no one comes. The aching in your empty belly gnaws at you with glee. Glee. Seems weird. My name, Procius, Chief. I apologize. Tell me what you want, or apology accepted.
Apology accepted.
He waves to a menial who brings in bread and milk. Eat it or leave it.
Eat it. We're starving.
It does not seem to be poisoned, and it nourishes you. I have need of you and your strength. I will help if I can. Tell me, I will kill you.
Tell me?
I shall. My daughter, my child, she is taken, offered to a terrible demon below. Goblins, she deserves it. You want me to rescue her? I will try or die trying.
You want me to rescue her?
Succeed and you may choose your reward. Fail and he shrugs.
I mean, I wanna save her, but it's worth noting that we are running out of time here. I don't know if we're gonna but let's save her. Wait.
What?
Did you say I think you said the wrong thing. Oh.
No, it was the only thing I could say.
Okay.
It was just continue. Try and escape. You will pay me richly for this. Take the adventure.
Take the adventure.
Whee! Watch the darkness, he declares as they start to lower you down. You hit the floor with a thud and peer into the darkness. You're blind, helpless, trapped. Something clatters to your feet from above. One of the spins shouts something down to you. Feel around on the ground, feel for the walls.
Feel around on the ground?
It's a dry wood torch. Something else falls from above and strikes you on the head. Tinderbox! Feel around or curse whoever hit you.
Feel around for the tinderbox.
Rubbing the bruise on your head, you reach down and find the tinderbox.
Light that torch.
They think I said save her yourself, which I'm pretty sure I didn't.
That's also what I thought happened, but...
Because I think if you say that, they do not like that whatsoever.
Well, but they did drop us down here and then hit us in the head with a tinderbox.
Below. Through an uneven rockfall at the far end of the cavern, you hear a murmur. Left, right, listen by the rocks.
Listen.
It's a whimpering coming from the other side of the pile of stones. The Sven girl, perhaps? She came in this way, but the cave-in has blocked off her path. You'll have to find another way to reach her. Reach her. Left or right?
Left.
Two stones are stacked on top of one another against the wall here. There's a T-junction.
Examine the stones.
There's nothing special about the two stones except they happen to be on top of one another.
Let's go right this time.
Here the cave system widens. Pendulous stalactites hang from the ceiling as if about to fall and skewer you into place. You skirt between them, following a thin safe path until a side passage opens on the left. Left or straight?
Left.
Turn and run from this little rumbling, or wait and see what happens?
Turn and run.
An enormous boulder is rolling speedily down the tunnel towards you. Use magic, pray to spirit, try something else.
Do we have boulder repelling magic?
We can see what it would do.
Yeah, let's see.
Okay.
Although we're like out of stamina, so.
Yeah. Oh, we could do invisible wall.
Create invisible wall.
That's three. Let's see what our other options are.
That's wall again.
Whoops. Okay. That would create glue, but we don't have any glue.
Sure.
And then fall would be float in air.
Is that useful? Can we get over it? Doesn't really say, like, can we get over it?
Right. Fix would cause fixedness, but we don't have a staff of oak sapling. And I think those are our only choices. So wall or float?
I think it's wall and it sucks.
You cast your spell just in time. The giant boulder hits your invisible wall. The boulder holds in place like a flying horse. The spell will not last long, so you better move on. Left or right?
Left.
A thick crystal seam glitters in the torchlight and a passageway appears on your right.
Look at the crystal.
A seam seems to be made of pure diamond. It was no doubt in quest of this that these tunnels were carved, but why is no one mining here now?
Ugh. Go straight on.
You plunge into a hidden pit and land on something soft. A lucky escape or look around?
Look around.
Oh. We're in a pit of snakes.
Oh, God.
Use magic, pray, try something else.
I guess we should try to use magic.
You ready a spell. Oops. Control non-intelligent creatures.
I mean, that would probably work.
Oops. I'm not. Create explosions, but we don't have any pebbles, so we can't do that. Zen hover in air, but we don't have that. So our only option here is law. Oh, neat.
Or go back and pray for the
right
for the spirit.
Oh, we can't. Well, we could rewind, but
oh. All right, let's cast law.
Okay.
We're not doing great here.
Seer says, can we parlay with the snakes? Apathetic of Plum says, why'd it have to be snakes? Retrosphere says, these snakes are the cure for the plague. Seer 235 says, maybe promise them the cave if they help us fight the goblins. Order them back or order them to help?
Order them to... How are they going to help? I mean, let's order them to help. I'm curious what that looks like.
They slither nearer and nearer, then they begin to climb the walls, holding themselves... a living ladder that stretches up the passage above. Climb it or test it.
There's, like, no way that works. test it?
You tug at the lowest rung. The snake seems firm and ready to take your weight.
climb it and then just kill yourself. There's no coming back from this.
Back on the firm ground, you watch as the spell leaves the snakes, and they tumble, snapping, hissing, and hungry, back to the cavern floor. You're soon back by the crystal seam where a crack splits the wall on the left. I forget where we went the last time.
We went straight last time, but it's reversed, right?
Maybe?
We're back to the crystal, because it was right or straight last time, so left is what used to be right, and straight is what's back.
Okay.
So I guess I want to go left.
You see a spot of sunlight up ahead and rush forward to find yourself back beneath the crack in the ceiling through which you came.
Oh my god. It's not going well. We're bad right now.
Yeah.
I guess go straight.
I wish there was there's a spell we could cast that would point us in the right direction, I think. But it's not letting us cast any magic right now. So.
I think we went left here last time, so we should go right this time.
The way is soon blocked by a large boulder. You turn back.
Go left? I've lost my bearings here.
You're back.
Yeah, okay.
So, straight.
Turn back? Oh, is that it? No, it's the crystal again.
Crystal, so.
Turn back. Go straight. Go left? Go left this time. We went right here last time.
This is different.
Yeah. Go left again. Go right.
Oh, this is back to the snake pit.
All right.
So the other way?
Straight?
Well, that would take us back to where.
No, it wouldn't, because we're coming back at it from the other direction, I think.
You get it? We did it! Okay. We got 4 stamina.
Yeah.
Look for traps, come with me.
Look for traps.
No switches or triggers. There is a claw mark. Something's coming.
Yeah, good luck fighting it with 4 stamina.
A manticore.
Yeah.
Look at it, fight it, use magic.
I mean, fighting it's going to be really hard, right?
Yeah.
And we have enough magic to use a magic on it, but I don't know what that looks like, really.
We could see.
I guess use a magic, right? That's our shot.
Worst case scenario, we can go back to the beginning of going in there and figure it out that way.
Sure.
You create wind, but we can't do that one. So we don't have a gale horn. That's useless. Causes slowness.
Wait, what's the DU options?
Oh. Cause clumsiness.
I mean, I don't think that's going to get us out of that fight.
Sorry. I already forgot which ones I've done. DP? Pep! Cause strength, but we don't have any fire water. Okay, so that was it. Those are our options.
What was F again?
Fog, summon darkness, or...
What's F-O-F? Oh, it's a force field.
We could try that.
But is that gonna work?
I don't know. We can make it clumsy. Wish you could do a fireball. Or make yourself bigger and, like, squish it.
And we're in a cave, though.
Oh, yeah. You're right.
Yeah, maybe clumsy is the thing.
Okay.
At the very least, that... Yeah. Well, it is what it is.
Okay. If you draw your sword now, you'll have an advantage, or you've gained yourself more time for further sorcery.
Well, let's draw our sword. We have one stamina. Good luck.
Motherfucker, we are dead.
Oh, well.
Okay, let's try again. Okay, I'm gonna defend on this one, but I'm still gonna lose one. You're still gonna die. Shit! Okay. We have to rewind.
Yeah. Maybe we should call it, though, because we gotta make room for Dylan.
This is literally the last thing before you go to car and start number two.
Oh, okay.
So we'll be okay.
All right, then.
Let's go... Do you want to start from when we went in here? Or do you want to go to earlier in the village?
Yeah, let's do this, because we can just go straight there and fight it with 10 stamina, right?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. And that should be much easier. Okay, take the adventure. Take the thing. Light it. Okay. Do you remember which way to go? But we made a bunch of lefts, and then we went straight.
Yeah, I think it's left. I think it's left from here.
Like, she was stacking the stones, so I think the stones being stacked is a good indication that we're going the right way.
Yeah, I think it's left from here, too.
Okay, yep, we did this. Like, this was... And then I think that was left. And that was a right, wasn't it?
I remember one of these gets us back into the snake pit.
Oh, yep, we're in the snake pit. It's okay, we'll do the law thing, and that'll still give me 9 stamina.
Okay.
Oh, wait, no, it won't. Or we could pray to the spirit.
Try the spirit this time.
Yep, same thing. Ladder, and that didn't cost us anything. Okay. Left or straight from here?
Oh, I don't remember.
Me neither. We should have written it down. Oh, well.
Straight? I think it's straight.
Okay. Yep. Okay. Come with me. Okay, let's try this again. Let's use magic again. Or should we?
I don't know how much it helped.
Yeah, you're right. Yeah, that didn't do a fucking thing last time. It still fought me with everything it had.
Yeah.
Alright. Defend. Shit. Okay. Fuck, this is gonna be hard. Maybe not. Oh, okay. Alright.
Alright.
It's scared, she whispers. You might not believe me, but you've scared it.
Yeah, it looks like you did.
Ooh, that's a close one. Oh, we're almost equal in the stamina that we have left.
Yeah.
We can do it. I believe in us. Okay, now we're equal. I could have attacked there. Oh my god, this is gonna be so close.
Yeah.
So.
All right.
And it's dead. Whew.
Good work.
Your sword blade seems almost to be possessed. It finds its way past the manticore, sweeping claws through its thick hide and down into its ancient, cruel heart. For a moment, it howls loud enough to make the wall shake, and then everything falls very quiet. Thank you, the Sphin Girl murmurs. This way. She leads you towards the light through a gap in the rocks to the pool of sunlight in the first cavern. Escape. You wave the torch, hoping to attract attention. Tell the girl to call up myself.
Tell the girl to call up.
Girl, call to your father. Procius, I'm here. A rope with a basket on the end. The girl first calls a voice from above. Procius, help the girl in. No, I come up first.
I mean, if we have to rewind, it's only a second, so help the girl in.
Haul away. The Sphins give a great cry and begin to pull, and the basket starts to slowly rise, spinning as it goes. The girl waves to you as she disappears up in the sunlight. Then she's gone. A minute passes. Nothing. Wait or call up?
Call up.
Throw down the rope. Nothing. The tunnel echoes very slightly, a noise from the depths. Perhaps the manticore was not alone. Start to climb or wait a little longer?
Ugh. Wait a little longer, and then we'll just rewind it, right?
You wait a little longer, settling down on your pack. You can imagine the celebration going on above ground, the tears and grateful reunion. No surprise if they lose track of you down here in the dark. Then, sure enough, the basket and rope tumble down. You clamber quickly in and they haul you up. The chief himself helps you out into the grass. My daughter tells you fight bravely. For that, I'm grateful. I invite you back with us, back to Torupani. Will you come? Do you want to go back with them or carry on to Kar?
We should go back with them. We need stuff.
We're so
not good right now.
As you enter the village, it erupts into celebration. They filled our stamina back up.
Good.
You're given a place to stay and recuperate from your long journey. A visit to the healing priest treats your wounds, and when you emerge, it's to find the village, before so somber and silent, now full in life. Flowers are tied to every rooftop, and bands of spins are playing music on long, strangely shaped lyres. You're whisked away into the dance by Perseus's daughter before the chief could give you his thanks again. The night is glorious.
It sure is.
You have saved us, my good friend. He presses two gifts into your hands, a pouch of 10 gold pieces, a fortune for a place like this, and a key. This opened the South City Gate of Kar, he tells you. I hope it is use. You take your leave. The path winds away from Torupani, and soon you're on a downward slope, away from the hills, through stepped rice fields. As you walk, you feel for the first time the loneliness of the path ahead. Though Kar is a busy city, it is cruel, and beyond Kar there's nothing but vicious wasteland. You'll have no one to trust in the days ahead. In the distance rises the wall of a great city, the first true stonework you've seen since the ruins of the giant city in the hills. And then it will zoom out and show us the path we took. Your journey through the Shamutani Hills is completed. Along the way, you've made no useful friendships. But have been given two useful keys to the cells of the Red Eyes and to the Gates of Kar. You've collected one magical artifact, a large lump of beeswax. You're still armed only with your original sword, have no rations, 19 gold pieces, and a spellbook. I'm going to save this to the cloud, which will give us a code that we can use for part two. And anyone can use our save if you want to start out in part two like us.
Yeah, with a bunch of money and no food. Also, weirdly, no one offers to sell you food.
Oh, that's weird. It is exactly the same as the code that I just finished with. Except you and I, we had very different things going on.
All right, so it's all nonsense. I hear you.
That's weird, though. They should be different. Yeah. Whatever. So we'll get through this little part and then we can exit. Crown of Kings has been stolen by the Archmage, taken across the backlands to Manpang. You've been sent to get it back. Should you fail, the whole of Kakabad will surely fall. LWC says, Gibaka, a spell that consumes all your food but transmutes your money into 19 gold coins. From the outpost settlement in Annaland, you cross the Shamutani Hills. Along the way, you explored an abandoned city of giants, traveled with a mini-mite who almost cost you your life, and fought and killed the dreaded Manticore. You faced starvation and disease. To survive, you used your blade often. You deceived, charmed, and tricked your way through. Your spirit guide changed as you changed, becoming the elephant. But now all of that seems a distant memory, for you are approaching Kar, the city port of traps. Founded on a ford of the Jabaji River, Kar was once a camp for the pirates who ambushed merchants sailing from Lake Lumley to the sea. The camp grew. It became a village, the village became a town, and now Kar is a magnet for ne'er-do-wells and thieves ruled over by a council of villains. Can't be avoided.
Let the city do its worst.
All right! It's a place of treachery and traps, so you'll have to be constantly on your guard as you cross. Your goal is the North Gate, the only entrance to the Backlands, and the next stage of your journey. If your quest is to succeed, you must enter the city port of traps and make it out alive. Umbi says, got the plague didn't make the cut? So part two is like way bigger than part one. So if we stream that, it would take more than one session. But this is
either you can't save in the middle.
You
or
can.
Is that we
you
just
can.
Did it? Okay.
Yep. Like if we exit right now and then we come back, it'll just it'll go right back in. Oh, after we do this, there's the village.
Sure.
You've not seen a living soul since you left the Svim. Okay, so there's where we'll leave off. That's weird that it says dolphin now. Because...
Yeah, that's nothing like an elephant. Although it said, like, that's all behind you now. Maybe that's what they meant. Like, that elephant left you back there.
Maybe. Let's, let me just look here real quick. I just want to see if, like, our stuff matches. Yeah, okay. That's weird that our spirit changed already, but okay. So, yeah, if we leave now and we come back later, we'll just be able to play. Like, it'll just load right to here.
Great.
So, thank you
for
joining. The
code never changes.
I guess, no, because, like, if I played on my phone, I got a different... spell. That's really weird.
Yeah.
It's not a big deal because part one doesn't take too long to play. But, yeah. And you can also do cross platform between your phone and the PC version, which is pretty cool. With that cloud save. So. Alright. Well, thank you for joining me, Art. Maybe we can come back and do part two at some point.
Yeah, we'll figure that out.
Did you like this?
It's interesting. Yeah, it's fun.
Yeah.
Yeah. it's weird how, like, low-tech it is.
Mm-hmm.
But
mm-hmm.
also, it's well-designed in its kind of low-techiness.
Yes, I feel you. I love this art. Oh, my gosh. You can buy these posters, and I want to buy them all someday, of all the maps.
Sure.
So pretty. Okay.
Way to hustle, Stevie Jacks.
And I like that, like, see that mountain is 3D, like, it's popping out over the... Alright, where can we find you on the internet, Art?
You can find me on Twitter at atemple. You can listen to Friends at the Table, which I am on most of the time these days, although I guess less coming up as we move into season 3. And
That's ominous.
I guess more on Stream Friends coming up. I'm talking to a couple people about a couple things. Just keep your ear to the ground for the next few days, and we'll see what happens.
Yay. You can find me at KelseyR713 on Twitter and KelseyR713.rocks and NerdyButFlirty.com. I would like to stream more, but I'm also auditioning for a play tomorrow, so we'll see. But I'd like to not drop completely off the face of the earth again this time. Maybe I'll do weekends.
Sure. So if you're a fan of Kelsey streaming, send a lot of bad vibes her way tomorrow.
And the first teaser poster for my next Batman fan movie is out, and you can find that in my Twitter pictures. It's not that far back. But that movie will be coming out in November, but we're going to release a teaser poster for every holiday, which is related to one of the villains in the Batman movie.
Is it Calendar Man?
It might be.
And I mean, it's Calendar Man or it's Holiday. I know how this works.
Yeah. I will be reprising my role as Harley. So that was super fun.
It's a good part.
So we're all doing stuff. Check it out on the internet. You can find Stream Friends at streamfriends.tv, twitch.tv/streamfriends, friendsofthetable.net. And I think that's it.
Oh, and go check Keith out at Keith J. Carberry on Twitter. Yes. And runbutton.net
and
/contentburger.biz.
And fuckdads.com, I think, is the other one.
Does he still have that?
Yeah.
All right.
But yes, check Keith out. All right.
Yeah, Keith is fun.
Thank you, everybody. Have a good night.
Bye.
Bye.